we are proud to bring you the storytellers from the CTP alumni. Ladies and gentlemen, we present to you, We Are Trailblazers.
Ago, we never imagined that we could get this far. Most of us were comfortably ensconced within the confines of our little universe. Some of us didn't feel the need to change and never intended for anyone to rock our boat. We may not have known who Bloom or Knowles were, but I guess wouldn't have made any difference to us.
Would one day become certified trainers. Most of us knew next to nothing about training then. Many of us didn't realize that we could have such a great impact on other people. After all, what did we know about sharing experiences, ideas, knowledge, and skills?
However, nothing that's great comes easy, especially when we are dealing with a room of people with different personalities. The frown before the sun, they say. Trainers bear huge responsibilities and have to meet great expectations. To make matters worse, they say there is no such thing as a perfect training session. There are countless things that could go wrong, whether it's a fire alarm going off in the middle of presentation or an unstable internet connection. It looks like there may be some truth in Murphy's Law.
And if that wasn't challenging enough, the world was jolted by a pandemic of an unprecedented scale in 2020, and things may never be the same again. Businesses have seen their training goals derailed due to stay-at-home orders. We have seen staff development initiatives suspended until things get back to normal.
Organizations now manage staff work remotely and onboard new employees from afar. Before COVID-19, they always had traditional training models at their locations. And true enough, with mandatory social distancing and the growing SOPs in person, training sessions are not even possible, let alone practical.
It is truly a trial by fire for all of us. No one knows if this change is temporary or permanent. Either way, just as a doctor, each trainer needs to do so as well.
Just what do we need to adjust? New materials, different approaches, a change of platform, or a change of mindset? Or are we looking at a total transformation? Whatever the case, change is good. What's more, progress is just not possible without change. But change can be difficult. Is it worth getting out of our comfort zone?
Those of us who love training would go the extra mile just to see our participants' eyes light up when they discover or learn something new. So, is it worthwhile to change? Yes, because to us, it's always about the learners. Learning happens within the learner and not in a slide deck or at the front of a class. We want to empower our learners with what they need to know or acquire.
Just like our father let go of the iceberg while we were paddling and trying to keep on, we trainers have to empower our learners to make their own decisions. And as they do, we learn about the sport. It's an endless self-discovery for me, learning how to work with other people and adapting and improvising as we go on. Trainers do not have to pick. We are all different, yet something in common, the willingness to learn.
We represent different cultures and hail from various parts of the world. Bahrain, Bangladesh, Brunei, Cambodia, Kazakhstan, Kenya, Malaysia, Nigeria, Oman, Pakistan, Tanzania, and UAE. Let's make a change from where we are to our training. Let's set a blazing trail. We have made training our passion and our profession, and this is our story.
Why did I become a trainer?
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 Why did you become a trainer?
Thank you, the alumni of FAA CTP.